Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
You're watching South Asian Newsline, and here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Wednesday, the 7th of August. India adopts wait and watch strategy as Yoon is appointed as interim government head in Bangladesh. US charges Pakistani man with alleged ties to Iran in foiled assassination plot. And ex-president Nawal Rajapaksa to contest Sri Lankan presidential poll. Now for all the news. India has evacuated all non-essential staff and their families from its embassy and consulate amid the unrest in Bangladesh. However, all Indian diplomats remain in Bangladesh and the mission are functional, government sources have stated. While India has maintained a wait and watch for situation developing in the neighbouring country, Indian Airlines is likely to resume operations from Wednesday. Air India also operated a special chartered flight from Dhaka to Indian capital New Delhi on Tuesday, carrying 199 passengers and 6 infants. Passengers coming from Bangladesh said, while the situation is relatively calmed down in Dhaka, they still await what comes next.
Situation is not so good, not so bad. The interim government has taken the control of the country and we do not know what comes next, but we hope for a better outcome.
Meanwhile, Bangladesh President Mohammad Shahabuddin has appointed Mohammad Yunus, Bangladesh's only Nobel laureate and an arch foe of ousted PM Sheikh Hasina, as the head to the interim government. Appointment of Yunus was a key demand of protesters who have said they won't accept any other government other than the one proposed by them. They have recommended 10 to 15 members for the interim government to President Shahabuddin, which they say could be finalized soon. Bangladesh currently has a power vacuum after its army chief announced Hasina's resignation, who was elected for a fourth straight term in January 2024. According to Reuters reports, situation spiraled out of Hasina control after the powerful military refused to suppress protest as ordered by her. Notably, the South Asian nation has been mostly ruled by the military in 50 years of its independence from Pakistan. And after securing 2 bronze medals in shooting in the Olympic Games in Paris, Manu Bhakur returned to India to a heroic welcome with thousands of supporters and family cheering up for her. Bhakur will return to Paris on August 10 as she is the flag bearer of the Indian contingent during the closing ceremony of the Games. Speaking to ANI, Bhakur said she is very happy to be back and the medals have given her inspiration to work harder. Bhakur opened India's medal tally in the ongoing Olympics after she secured 3rd place in the women's individual 10-meter air pistol event, becoming the first ever women's shooter to win an Olympic medal for India. Following that, Sarabjot Singh and Bhakur won the bronze medals in the 10-meter air pistol mixed team event, which was India's first ever shooting team medal.
मुझे बेहद खुशी है कि लोगों से इतना सारा प्यार मिल रहा है और इतना सपोर्ट कर रहे हैं और मैं उम्मीद करती हूँ कि आगे भी ये यूं ही बरकरार रहेगा मैं भी यूं ही मेहनत करती रहूंगी और अपना बेस्ट देती रहूंगी
Meanwhile, in a major setback to India's medal hopes from the wrestling arena, grappler Vinesh Fogat was on Wednesday disqualified from the 50 kg women's wrestling event, having been weighed over the limit for her event. Vinesh had scripted history by becoming the first Indian women wrestler to reach the gold medal bout on Tuesday night. However, India can continue to hope for medals from the athletics arena. Moving on, the Indian diaspora in Canada commemorated the 5th anniversary of the abrogation of Article 370 in Kashmir with a celebratory event in Mississauga. The gathering highlighted the positive impact of the historic move on the region. A report.
Members of the Indian diaspora in Canada gathered in Mississauga to mark the 5th anniversary of the abrogation of Article 370 in Jammu and Kashmir on Tuesday night. Organized by the Hindu Forum Canada, the event saw over 150 Hindus and Sikhs coming together to celebrate the Indian government's decision, which they believe has led to positive changes in Kashmir. The participants prayed, danced, and expressed their gratitude for what they viewed was a historic and transformative move.
Today, Canadian Hindus and Sikhs, we are all very happy and we are celebrating together the 5th anniversary, and whatever the Mr. Modi's government has done, nobody was dared to do it, and we are very, very proud of it.
To celebrate doing the right thing when it works out. If you remember back 5 years ago, many of the so-called experts were saying that this would cause catastrophe and the sky is going to fall and all these different things, but no, Kashmir got better because of that, and it's important to hammer that home and make that point.
India revoked the special status and semi-autonomy granted to Jammu and Kashmir in 2019. Dividing the state into two federally administered regions. The move has strained relations with Pakistan, which also claims the region, and has engaged in multiple conflicts with India over the territory. New Delhi continues to assert that Jammu and Kashmir is an integral part of India, with no external entity having the standing to challenge its decisions on the matter.
Moving on. A Pakistani man with alleged ties to Iran has been charged in the United States in connection with a foiled plot to assassinate a U.S. politician and government officials, the Justice Department said on Tuesday. According to a criminal complaint, a Pakistani national identified as Asif Merchant had sought to recruit people in the United States to carry out the plot in retaliation to the U.S. killing of Iran's Revolutionary Guard's top commander, Qasem Soleimani, in 2020. Former President Donald Trump had approved the drone strike on Soleimani during his tenure in office. While the court documents do not name the alleged targets of the plot, the Reuters report suggests Trump was discussed as the potential target. Notably, in a separate incident last month, Trump, the Republican candidate in the November 5 presidential election, was wounded in an assassination attempt at a campaign rally in Pennsylvania. Reacting to the arrest, Pakistan's foreign ministry has said it is in touch with U.S. authorities and await further details. And Namal Rajapaksa, son of former Sri Lankan President Mahinda Rajapaksa, was on Wednesday named as the SLPP candidate for the presidential election, hence officially ending Rajapaksa family's backing to the incumbent Ranil Wickremesinghe. 38-year-old Namal's entry has made the election a four-cornered contest. Besides, President Wickremesinghe, the main opposition leader, Sajith Premadasa, and the Marxist JVP leader, Anura Kumara Desanaike, are already in the fray. The Rajapaksa, Mahinda, Basil and Gotabaya were instrumental in Wickremesinghe winning the parliamentary vote in July 2022 to take over Gotabaya's remaining term. It was soon after the unprecedented development of mid-April 2022 when the island nation declared its first ever sovereign default since gaining independence from Britain in 1948, and almost civil war-like conditions followed as unrest spread amid locals over inflation and other economic stress that had led to Gotabaya's ouster. Moving on. Torrential rains in Nepal since Monday morning have resulted in inundation along the embankments of Bagmati River, severely affected slum dwellers in Kathmandu. The absence of proper alert system for those living near the river has become an issue of major concern. Students were seen wading through the flood waters while office goers were stuck alongside the flooded roads. Nepal records high mortality due to landslides and flooding during monsoon due to tough terrain and unplanned urbanization. The Himalayan nation this year is expecting more than average monsoon rainfall.
Hey, sarkarle aaj sa kehi gare hai na uthauni bhanni rakhcha balin le aba yo narahni bhancha uthauni bhancha khai ke garcha khai dherai barsha bhaisake baseko aba ghar ma aba khola pasisakyo 3-4 chuti bhaisake mero ta yaha paseko.
पानीको सतह बढ्दै गर्दाखेरि अब जनधनको क्षति पनि भएको छ. यो वर्ष मात्रै 3 पटक बाढीको प्रकोपमा परेका छौँ, जसमा एकजनाको केही योभन्दा अगाडिको बाढीमा केही दिन अगाडिको बाढीमा एकजना मान्छेको मृत्यु पनि भएको छ. अनि हामीले खाने लाउने हाम्रा चाहिँ छोराछोरीहरूले पढ्ने पठन पाठन गर्ने चाहिँ विद्यालयका सामग्रीहरू पूर्ण ढङ्गले चाहिँ नष्ट.
The Indian Air Force began its first ever multinational exercise on its own soil, Tarang Shakti 2024, in Sulur, Tamil Nadu, on Tuesday. In the curtain raiser of the event, indigenous LCA Tejas fighter jet flown by Air Marshal A.P. Singh intercepted German, French and Spanish contingent taking part in the war games. Speaking to ANI, IF Chief Air Chief Marshal V.R. Chaudhary said, "The war game is a huge feather in India's cap. We have been carrying out bilateral exercises with many countries over the years and this is the first time we are doing a multilateral exercise of this scale. It's a challenge and Air Force and all participants have lived up to the challenge," he said.
"We have been doing bilateral exercises all these years. It is not that we have not done, we have been doing bilateral. It's only that we have not had the experience to conduct a multilateral exercise. After taking part in many such multilateral exercises in other countries, we have also now gained the experience to do it here."
The first multinational exercise by India has participation from 30 countries, with almost 10 participating air forces bringing their fighter aircraft. The exercise is divided into two phases, with the first phase scheduled from August 6 to 14 in Sulur. The next phase will begin on 29th of August until 14th of September in Western Jodhpur city. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.